I saw some comments saying that I should start every video from taking a sip out of this, but there's no water in it, so. Hello everyone, welcome back to my second YouTube video. Before I get started, I just wanted to say thank you to everyone who watched my first video. I had a lot of fun making it, and I'm really excited to film this next one. It's gonna be a lot shorter because at the beginning I had to show you my workspace and my trash. Now I get to skip all that because I can just get right into the products. As you can see, my background is a little different because I have color-changing lights. So I wanted to make it on theme today with my Valentine's Day card because Valentine's Day is coming and I have done nothing. I was messing around with some stuff last night and one of the things I got into was my mom's StampTV kit, Hearts and Flowers. There's a glare from my light. Oh, I'm trying to, you can see my light. So, I love when it doesn't focus. Okay. So this kit includes, you have my heart bloom set, tropical bloom set, 24 sheets of pure luxury cardstock, you have my heart die set, tropical blooms die set, and a storage box, which is good because I don't have any storage. So for the set we're going to be using is the You Have My Heart stamp set that comes in the kit, and this comes with a set of dies. Almost knocked one off. We're going to be cutting out a lot of images, and something I want to do in this card is I kind of want to make it interactive. I don't know if you guys have heard of those cards that you open and stuff falls out of it, but I want to make a bunch of hearts fall out of it, and that's exactly what I'm going to do. I'm going to cut a bunch out with dies, and then I'm going to put them in the card and have them fall all over. So just like the last video, there will be a giveaway in this one as well, and because I'm using new foils that my mom has made, we will be giving away all the sparkle and sequin foils. All the sparkle and sequin foils. This is a $50, closer to $60 value, and you get all 8. And all the names will be included in the description because I don't have them yet. I'm literally reading them from the text that my mom provided me. So I'll decide in the video what the comment should be that you leave in the comment section, and it'll be really fun. I just got these foils. I literally opened up a box yesterday with them, and I've been having so much fun with them. Everything's so glittery and high def. So the color sequins we're gonna... The color sequins we're gonna be using today is pink and black because I wanna be using the Passionate Pink foil. I wanna embellish it with sparkling silver because I think those colors will go really nicely together. Also, in my last card I used red and gold and black, and I wanted to try something else, and also I didn't know how to fold up the foils back in their packaging, and these ones aren't open yet, so it looks better. I think the pink will look really good. I'm really excited for it. So without further ado, let's get to the card. Okay, so there are many overlapping steps in the card that I had just made, but I think I'm going to start with the stamping. So I'm going to be using this image right here. It's like a swirly heart outline, and it has a die with it, so I'm gonna start by lining this up. As you can see, it's a little red because I'm not good at cleaning. I am going to stamp it right here, and the two inks we're going to be using today, one is the Black Onyx Ink Cube, and you can get that in the Neutral Ink Cube Assortments pack. We are also going to be using the Passionate Pink Ink Cube. This is really pretty, and I think it matches the pink foils really well. We're going to be stamping this image with both colors. Getting a little better with the magnets. I figured this out, and I'm keeping it off my desk desk, but needless to say, it's still a problem sometimes. So we're gonna ink this first one up with the pink because it's lighter. Ooh, I would file that under crisp. Next, we are going to stamp the other side of the image right here, and we are going to use black. So I have to wash this so the colors don't interfere and just make my card look like trash. So I just gotta get the double scrubber out. What just happened? This is a good time to announce to take care of your stamping stuff because it can be broken. We're going to take this half of the double scrubber. Can't believe that just happened.
Why does everything of mine have to break? I made a very adult decision before I started filming today. I brought the Windex up here prior to filming, so I wouldn't have to make a mess and then panic and go get it. See, I know what I'm doing, guys. I know what I'm doing. Okay, next we're going to take the black ink and just cover it on there, and over it goes. Oh my gosh. Did that just ruin everything? The answer to that question would be yes. That over there prior to clamping. Okay, you know, that one isn't perfect either, but it's okay. And now the last thing I want to stamp is this phrase, and it says, what does it say? I love everything about you. That seems fitting. So I'm going to put it over here, and don't worry, I already checked. The heart is right here and right here. Do not need another mistake to be broadcasted with my mom's following. Ooh! All right, next up we're going to be using the Kick Shot for cutting out these dies. Now, I've messed up so many times on these dies, and I want to try to make it perfect. Okay, that one's not that bad. Now that both of these are cut out, we are going to work on cutting out this phrase into a perfect rectangular shape. Now, I'm not gonna lie, I am absolute garbage with this. I would also like to thank the people that shared with me that the handle was underneath the paper cutter. I know some of you were like, I don't know if this is too obvious. Yes, it was too obvious, and I still missed it. This gives me so much stress. Measurements aren't exactly my thing. When I cook, I don't measure anything. That's why sometimes it's not good, but that's the risk you take when you eat my food. See, sometimes the results are good. It's just most of the time they're not. Here is a close-up shot. So the next thing we're gonna focus on is we need to cut out some glittery centers for this. There is a hair on my finger. We're going to be doing a pink one for this one and a silver one for this one. Now, they don't have a foil that exactly fits in the center of that heart, but they do have this one, which is a lot bigger when, here, I'll pull it out. Here's the size of the heart, and as you can see, they fit pretty well. This one would actually fit very well, but I'm going to actually use a die once the foil's on them, and then I'll seal them to the center of this. I'm going to be using the smallest smooth-sided heart die from the set, and I'm going to be using this one. I know it looks like I could be using this one, but I don't think it'll really fit, and I want it to be completely covered with foil. I don't want any white specks, and also, this will be extremely hard to line up, and I do not have enough faith in myself for that. Do you like these scissors? Sometimes I cut my hair with them. I cut it out, and I'm going to fit it in here with some foil. Now, we'll first do the sparkling silver. Now, as you can see, this looks very rainbow, but if it's not under an intense light, it still looks very rainbow, which is very cool. There's definitely like a silver color to it. It's so cool looking. Oh, look at that in the camera. Ooh, I feel like I'm at Coachella. So next thing you want to do is you want to put it up against the folded side. I know that for sure. And you want to put the foil on top of the image shiny side up, because I almost made that mistake yesterday. I don't know what happens. I don't want to know what happens. But the point is, I didn't mess up. Do you know how I figured it out? I watched a Gina K video. So you wanna make sure that you turn this on and have it heat up. You wanna put it to the 3 setting. Obviously, I don't know what the other settings are, I just know this is the one that is best for the foil. I feel like you could slip a quesadilla in here and get the same results, but we're not going to be doing that today. So it smells like burnt plastic, so I am going to go ahead and feed that through. Once the light is green too, it also indicates when you can push it through. Okay, as you can see, it's going to slowly pull it in and melt it and really fuse everything together. So here is what it looks like. Now this is the craziest part, ready? Now as you can see, it's very, very rainbow, but you can also see the silver in there. So that came out just as I wanted it to. I just cut this foil without knowing there was one underneath. Excellent, okay. Now you pick one of the foils that you cut out. You line it up with your image. You wanna make sure the image is fully covered so there isn't any black parts sticking out. And then you just want to feed it through your quesadilla maker. I need some like sexy Valentine's music playing with this. The next next thing we're gonna foil is Foil Mates, known as Blooming Hearts. And we're gonna use this one. Now, we're not gonna do a full sheet. We're only gonna do like a part of it, just cause I want like a little landing strip. I don't want it full Blooming Heart, just like a strip. Okay, so I just cut out a long piece of the silver and I cut out about an inch wide piece of this so I can fit it to my card. And we're just gonna do the same thing that we did with the hearts, and you might need to adjust a little bit because it's skinnier. Feed it through. Wait. There it is. Oh, she's hot. Oh, she's hot. Let's do another reveal. Ooh. There she is. As previously mentioned, we're going to be using this small die from the set we've been using, and we're just gonna fit it on there. So it covers up all the spaces of the foil. It doesn't have to be lined up perfectly with the heart, so we just wanna get a full shiny heart cut out from here. So if it moves a little bit, it's okay. But that turned out really well. Look at that. Mmm. Nice. Okay, now we're going to repeat that with this one. I thought this would be a good reminder that these are very shiny, and if you're greasy like me, your fingerprints will show up on it, so try not to touch them that much, or you can maybe wipe them down after, or maybe just try not to be greasy. Okay, so the last thing we're gonna do is cut out background images for these dies. So as you can see, there is a bigger one of these hearts. I'll show you the original one that we used. That's this one. As you can see, they layer well, and they're the same exact like shape, so it'll work really well. Guys, I just lost the die. Oh wait, there it is, okay. That will conclude die cutting for this card. I'm trying to get the pink shine in there. There we go. All even, all matching, all ready to get stuck together for the rest of their lives. So now we are going to begin sealing all these together, and there are many methods to get a good fit on there. Oh my gosh, there is another hair. That's not my hair. I don't know whose hair that is. Looks like James's eyebrow hair. Oh my god, you know what? The hair is gonna be part of the card now. It's meant to be. Okay, so if you just line it up and press, should go on there. I can't pick up anything. And now this one, remember, your fingerprints will be on there. So refrain from grease. You want to line this up because they aren't exactly like the same hearts, but they will line up very nicely. Ooh, there we go. Please excuse my fingerprints, but there it is. Some ways you can make sure that you get it right on the center is you can line it up and make sure it is there. You can practice it 800 times without tape before you finally go through with putting tape on. You could have a drink so you don't care about the placement till later when your card isn't even done. And there we have it. These are our two hearts. As you can see, the layering is nice, the shine is nice, and the border is nice. So it's gonna add a lot of dimension to the card. I've learned the right strength to enforce a good fold mark now, so we don't have to worry about that. God, my purple is clashing so much. So next thing we're going to do is seal the card onto the backing, and I'm going to do that with, once again, Thermoweb's tape. Shout out Thermoweb. Also shout out Thermoweb for these foils. We're gonna put the silver on this side because last time I put it on the other side, and I just want to mix it up. So we're gonna add some strips of tape. Beautiful. And for these, I've decided I want to put them on there while they're popping out a little bit, like two little hearts, kind of like that. So I am going to use 3D foam squares by Scrapbook Adhesives. To get this layering on there, you're going to have to glue right here and then stick it to right there, because otherwise this part is going to be popped up and that'll look weird. So you want to just put a little bit of tape there and kind of make them a little off if you want. You can make them right dead on each other. I don't know, it's up to you. My paper cutter was right underneath my foot with the blade up. Oh my gosh. Could have been a very different video in a couple seconds. Sealing my toes back on with Thermoweb tape. So I put them like this actually because I wanted the pink to be over the silver and I didn't want it to just be silver on silver. And that's the front of our card so far. And the last thing we need to do is add our greeting, but I want to add a layering to this. So I'm gonna cut out a little pink backing and then I'll add it to the card. So there, I fitted a white white part in the inside to write a message on the lovely card. And one more thing I'm gonna do for this. So last thing I did was I cut out a bunch of these little hearts, and I'm just gonna finish writing my message in here, and then once I'm ready to give it to my person, James, I am going to close it so when he opens it, they all fall out like confetti. And as much as it is a fun surprise, it is also a pain because I do not plan to clean it up. So that is one of my wonderful gifts to James.
So now I am going to give it to James. We were talking about what we wanted to do for Valentine's Day, and we just had our anniversary, so we already had like a really nice night out. So I think we're just gonna sit at home and be gross.
I just made shrimp scampi for dinner. How are you feeling?
Fat. I'm gonna have a biscuit.
Yeah.
That's so good.
Okay, so I'm going to give you my card now.
Okay. Next level layers. And it says, I love everything about you. And it's got some hearts inside. Except how your nose whistles as you sleep. Happy Valentine's Day, love, Rina. And then there's also a thing on the other side. This coupon ensures one full hour of Rina time when she doesn't want to.
That's a good gift.
I love it.
I think we need a couple shots of you with the card. It's a nice robe.
Supposed to read the back of this?
Wait, no.
Where could I go to buy the products used to make this piece of art?
Well, James, I'm sure you could find all these products at Gina K Designs. Say, James, can you help me read the winners of last week's video giveaway?
The winners are Chelsea Johnson from Everett, Washington, Patricia Dunbar from San Jose, California, and Linda Huffman from Davenport, Florida.
Yeah, we had a lot of comments on the last video, so we just gave more people prizes.
Can't be mad with more prizes.
James, what should these people do to let us know that they won?
Just send an email with the sentence, I won the Rina K giveaway, to info@ginakdesigns.com. That enunciated well.
Yes, that was perfect.
Perfect.
So that is the end of the video and this tutorial for this card. I hope you enjoyed it. And I know that I need a video question before the end of it, so I think the comment that will put you in the running for the 8 sparkle and sequin... Don't know how to say that word. The 8 sparkle and sequin foils that my mom is providing for this giveaway is, what is your best memory from Valentine's Day? It can be with someone you love, it can be with someone you hate, it could be just you at home watching the same videos on repeat while eating taco dip until you can't see straight anymore. That was my favorite, it was 2 years ago. But anyway, thank you for watching again, and I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope to see you in the next one. I'm not sure what I'm gonna do yet, but I know my mom's sending me a lot of good stuff, so just remember you can get all these products from GinaKDesigns.com, and I will leave all the information in the description of what products I use and how you can order them if you want them. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you!